Welcome to the Tuckcast with a splash of bourbon presented by Tuckasegee Fly Shop and Guide Service. Tuckasegee Fly Shop and Guide Service has three convenient locations to serve you. 3 Depot Street, Bryson City, 530 West Main Street, and 110 Depot Street, Waynesville, all of those in North Carolina. Tuckasegee Fly Shop and Guide Service is your number one stop prior and after your epic fly fishing adventure in Western North Carolina. Tuckasegee Fly Shop and Guide Service proudly carries industry-leading brands such as Simms, Orvis, Corkers, Rio, Scientific Anglers, Hatch, Nautilus, Lampson, Fishpond, Scott Fly Rods, Echo, Umpqua, Hairline, Nature Spirit, Peak, Norweis, plus a large selection of flies and streamers. Check out www.tuckflyshop.com for streamflow information. Book a lesson or guide a trip, or even shop for your favorite Tuckasegee Fly Shop gear. That would be at flyshopusa.com. Follow the crew on Facebook at Tuckasegee Fly Shop, Instagram at Tuckasegee Fly Shop, and on YouTube at Tuckasegee Fly Shop. Here in our Silver Shop today, we have Bobby the Bearded Wonder Bennet, Coach Dale Lisa Collins, Justin the Grill Master Pilot, and I'm your host, Shannon Big Mess Messer. Welcome, everybody. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Hope everybody's doing well today.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent.
Morning.
This morning?
Morning.
This morning. We got a
man. I'm still not in the zone for these morning.
I got you.
We gave you an extra hour.
Two extra hours.
Come on,
one
man.
Time change kicked in.
Yeah.
The phone's ringing.
Phone's ringing. Get the phone, Dale.
So with that being said, on the time thing there, we got a great show here for today. We're going to talk a lot about the upcoming product for spring, some of the changes there, some of the things that's coming down the pipeline that you definitely want to tune into, listen to. Try to get you a fishing report there as well. But also keep in mind that we are starting our winter hours. Those winter hours are 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Monday through Saturday, still currently closed on Sunday. And that's kind of where we're going to ride that, usually up until March when we do that.
For sure.
Excellent. I got to step out for a phone call.
Yeah, we're operating a shop right now while we're doing a podcast. So makes it fun. Fun stuff. So, yeah, Shannon said we're going to talk a little bit later here in the show about some of the stuff coming up from Simms. We're also going to talk about some Grundins. If you're not familiar with Grundins, this will be an opportunity for you to go and look at their website and kind of see what they've got now. They don't have the new products that are coming out yet on their website because they're new for the spring. Yes. And there'll actually be some YouTube content from us on some of that, and we're going to talk about that here a little bit too.
Morning, everybody. Hey, Dale. Welcome to the show.
Anyways, yeah, it's crazy. We got set up to do this. We had some customers walk in.
That's great.
Had to work with them, and then we sit down to do it again, and then the phone rings. So
it's good.
It's part of.
I hope third time's a charm.
Interrupted. That's business.
Getting interrupted a little bit, but just part of it. So I assume everybody had a. And there goes my alarm.
Somebody. It is what it is.
Y'all keep talking.
What are we talking about?
Talk about like Simms stuff, the new Simms stuff.
Oh, yeah. So,
some new products coming out.
It's hard to believe 2022 is winding down. You know, for the last 2 years, yeah. We've been battling through shipping problems and things like that. Vendors not able to get products to us. So, mm-hmm. I feel like, you know, Bobby and I have done a really good job of making sure the shop has stayed stocked and people have choices. So, so I feel like that's been in good shape. So this year, you know, 2022, we're wrapping it up. You know, we know inflation's happening. Prices are going up. They're continuing to go up. And that's certainly going to be the case in 23, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
So for the next, I don't know, month, 6 weeks.
Get your cheaper stuff while you can.
This is your discount.
This is your discount.
If you need waders, buy them now.
Yeah.
So, because the price is going up really soon for across all the brands, not just Simms, but Orvis and anyone else, I imagine. So, just know that. You haven't seen any sales come from Tuck Fly Shop. We are running free shipping on Fly Shop USA through the end of the year. But in terms of sales on waders or anything, you know, with all the prices going up in the spring, this is your discount. So, you know, things are going up. I think the tributary is going up to 249.
Bruce. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
From $199. Yeah,
yeah.
So $50 there. So yeah, some of it's kind of hard pills to swallow there, but you know, that's really the only negative thing about the 2023 products that we've seen. I think there's a lot of positive in the fly fishing industry right now. And it came across anytime a company that starts as a family company sells to a big conglomerate, Sims and Vista, okay, it's always scary. Like, what's going to happen?
Mm-hmm.
But sitting through some meetings with our reps, I think it's honestly going to be a good thing. I mean, we've always said competition breeds excellence. So I think it's going to be good that somebody's pushing Sims mm-hmm. with the new Grundins line. So that's another brand Shannon's going to have to say on that intro.
Yeah, have to get it. So before we jump into all that, how was everybody's Thanksgiving?
He said talk.
No, well, I wanted to be like chit-chat, like
small talk.
Yeah.
We chatting.
I'm sure everybody wants to know how your turkey turned out that you were cooking.
Man, so my smoker started running Tuesday night about 11 o'clock and didn't turn off until Thursday evening about 4:30. Started off with a brisket.
That's a lot I did of pellets. A brisket.
Yeah. Went through 40 pounds of pellets, almost 30 pounds of pellets in 3 days.
What's the carbon footprint of your Thanksgiving?
It's fine. It's fine. It tasted great. Don't worry about it, Dale.
That volcano's put out more.
Yeah. No, it's a – so we started off doing a brisket. Spoke to brisket for about roughly 18, 19 hours for some of my cousins. Yeah. Man, it was like the hardest. I mean, I couldn't
– Were you every now and then unwrapping it and just reaching in and pulling a little piece and tasting it?
I come close.
After about 12 hours.
Yeah. I go out there and start touching it. You know, you can see that it's getting tender. And it has like that jello type of thing. You're like, yeah, this is going to be good.
you like just like poke it?
Yeah.
Like the Pillsbury Doughboy.
Just watch it jiggle.
Yeah, and then that Thanksgiving morning, my dad and I, we spatchcocked a 20-pound turkey.
You what?
Spatchcocked.
My wife said that, and I ran.
That's what you do, man. Yeah. Makes it cook faster.
Yeah, cut it, take the backbone out, spread it, set it on the grill. It smoked for about 5 hours. Meat church seasoning on all of it. It's good stuff.
It's meat church, baby.
And then that afternoon, the secret of these pellet grills is like baking on them. You could do like pies and things like that too. So I did a homemade from scratch, like apple pie that I took to my family's that evening.
On the grill.
That's pretty cool. It gets that crust kind of, you know, like char and, you know, barky and good.
That's pretty cool. I've never had a pie, I don't think, at least, done on the grill.
Yeah. Anything you cook in an oven, you can cook on a Traeger. It's basically just a big convection.
And it is has that like any smoker or just Traeger?
Any pellet smoker. Okay. Yeah.
What about charcoal grill?
I'm sure there's a way to do it.
I'm sure there's a way. But how the pellet smokers work, and it's a convection, and how like it cooks.
It rolls
and,
it around.
Yeah.
It, so
it
it's
keeps
even.
Everything even. Yeah.
The Weber.
Yeah.
They do that with the charcoal Webers. You know,
they make pies?
Their dome design.
Yeah.
That you get that convection going there as well. And I think it's more of kind of that shape of what you're looking for there.
Yeah.
I think smoking you could do. I just don't know about cooking a pie.
See, mine was,
I'd like to try it.
375 for 55 minutes or what, you know, 50 minutes or whatever it was. You know, just like you would do it in an oven.
Hmm.
Except instead of putting it in the oven, I just put it on the smoker.
So you got a Weber.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So do it. Do a pie. Even if you get a
pie,
I don't know if I want to wreck a pie. On
Mrs.
Just an
no, seriously, a Mrs. Smith's pie.
Yeah,
out of the
they're
frozen.
Already cooked. I've done those too, man. It turns out good.
But the idea is to see if one side of it's overcooked, the other side.
No, I'm serious. I mean, it's like boom. Yeah. Let's see where it's at. Document it. Video document this.
Yeah, Dale.
Seriously,
science
let's
project.
See where we're at.
Document.
Yes.
Make it a science project for your kids.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously.
And a way you can test too, if your grill has hot spots, you get canned biscuits. And put them all across it and see which one cooks first.
Tasty, I bet. Let me test this one.
If you can do biscuits, you can do a pie.
You know, I had to do that. You know, I had to make sure my grill was even.
Yeah,
it's not. But you know, whatever.
So you smoked the turkey?
I did.
How long did you do yours for? On a charcoal grill?
Yeah,
that's impressive.
Yeah,
that's harder to keep the heat right.
I hit a button, set it, and just let it go for 5 hours. Put a little butter on it.
A little more finesse.
Yeah.
So. I watched a YouTube video. I was like, oh, that's easy.
There you go.
YouTube University, man.
No, it wasn't easy. I was shocked. Lowe's actually had what I needed to set up in the Weber. the little trays that keep the charcoal on the sides.
Yes.
For indirect heat. So you just start the coals on one side, and they slowly burn their way across. So kind of like that snake technique we
talked about. Yeah, the snake thing works.
Yeah.
Where it burns all. That's how you do a brisket.
That's what this guy called it, but it was just a pile.
Yeah.
So, but it burned across, and it was working perfect, but then, like, those coals ran out, but I still needed to cook some more. So I had to get the other side going. So that side was going to sleep, but I had to get the other side going. So there were some, as Cabell would say in roasting coffee beans, there were some curves.
Yeah.
I don't know it. The curves didn't mess up anything. It was still super tender, juicy, and amazing flavor.
I was going to say, did it turn out good?
It did. I don't know if I ever hit 165, but nobody got sick.
I was about to say, at the end of the day, as long as nobody got sick, you're golden.
You just need a thermopen, man. They're cheap. You get them on Amazon, you just go out there and just check that thing every once in a while.
I had one.
Yeah.
I had a thermometer.
What did it say?
It never said 165.
What did it say?
It said like 130.
Oh God, you're going to kill somebody.
You got worms or something,
but
brother.
But at the end of the day.
Hey, we're all vertical.
But at the end of the day, you've got to remove it before it hits 165 because it still continues to cook even when it's off the heat.
That's what they say, yeah.
Well, so
I pulled mine at 160, and I have a wireless probe from Meter is a brand. And, like, I left it in there while it rested, and it cooked down to 175, and I pulled it at 160, and it rested for 25 minutes.
Yeah. Well, there you go.
You know,
Bill's talking on his watch.
Oh, is he?
Phones are growing crazy.
Dude, it's been a morning. But anyway, I walked into this conversation about food here, of course. I guess you're talking about Thanksgiving.
Yeah. I was just like, how'd everybody's food turn out? Because, you know, we talked about that before. How do you cook your, how's everybody cooking?
So this year, Tanya was in charge of cooking the turkey.
Yeah.
My sister-in-law, she did the SmackDown sweet tater casserole, which is primo. But this year, Tanya, ended up cooking the turkey for everybody, and it was her first.
Yeah,
and she did a great job with it.
Sweet,
you know, she did really well with it. Just your basic, with you know, all your, you know, your veggies, mirepoix, however you say that fancy word at the bottom of the pan.
Oh, so she did it like that. She put all that in there.
Yeah, that we don't no stuffing in the turkey itself, but you know, going under the skin with an herb butter, you know, putting that in, then. Mm-hmm. You know, doing all the other stuff there, and she did a really good job. It was nice there. I got the carving duties, of course, while Braden and I actually went squirrel hunting that morning there. So it was good. We had a good Thanksgiving.
My paper bag didn't catch on fire.
That's right. You're the paper
never
bag,
has.
Man. You're the paper bag.
For
man.
30 years, it's never caught on fire.
Do you damp it? Like, is it what? You just,
put it on. Yeah. You cut that one side of it out and set it right under it and staple the ends. And salt pork did its job. Didn't have to baste at all.
So you're doing a whole turkey, right? Everybody here did a whole turkey, I guess, right?
It was like a 18 and a half pound.
Yeah, ours
turkey.
Was 20 something there because of a lot more folks there. We're going to do a turkey breast here. That's to be next weekend, actually. Alex and Madeline will be up for Christmas. That'll be their only time they can come up and be with Christmas. So we were talking last night about doing just a breast. I think Matt talked about they just do a.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just do a breast.
I think the hardest thing with that is there's not as much fat and stuff like there is in a whole bird.
But you don't get that dark meat, you know.
Yeah.
Dark meat's where the flavor is at.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
And the legs and the thighs. And
tell you, trust me, when I was cutting that turkey up, I was picking a dark meat.
Oh, that's part of cutting it. You get to pull all that right at the bottom of the turkey, in the pan.
Dude, it's like the best. The best. So we're going to do one of those. We'll do that kind of for the Christmas thing there. And,
that's good stuff, man.
I think everybody here did a whole turkey except for.
Well, nobody had disasters. Yeah. You know, like
no, everything went well.
The turkey so or the dog here, got it.
Here's
or,
the other thing about my turkey I did.
End up it's a Chinese turkey.
That was Matt there on the phone trying to figure out if he wants to take his trip today. So,
oh, yeah.
Oof.
I rescheduled mine.
Yeah. So the finishing touch on my bird was you take. Basically, 4 sticks of butter. I don't know what that equals. A lot.
That equals goodness.
You melt it. You melt it. You take the turkey, and you make a butter boat out of aluminum foil. Yeah.
Sounds glorious.
And you put it meat down in the butter.
Mm-hmm.
Put it back on the smoker.
Yeah.
And then that butter just goes.
It just sucks into it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was.
That's kind of the idea on a steak. When you take a steak off, you put butter on top of it. Yes. As it sucks the juices in, it sucks the butter into the meat.
I make my own garlic butter.
Yeah.
And whenever I pull them off and let them rest, I'll tin them with aluminum foil on my cutting block.
Throw some butter on them.
And that's when you know that you're ready to eat. When the butter's melted, you're ready to eat.
That's it.
It's about 15 minutes.
It's good stuff.
So you doing like clarified butter or just butter?
Just butter.
Just sticks of butter.
Put it in the microwave, soften it up, good to go. I've got like a fancy like European butter where I use like Tillamook butter and then garlic, mash the garlic up and melt it and mix it. Then
four sticks is a lot of butter.
Did y'all have any toddies while you were cooking?
Mm-mm.
Yeah. No, I did.
Yeah, I did.
No. I had Tito's.
I was like, it's 9 a.m. Let's do this.
It was probably lunchtime because we didn't put our bird in until like 10:30 or 11. But, yeah.
Yeah. I had to get the grill going quick for the smoker. It takes a while.
Yeah, because we ate at like 1:30.
Yeah.
Because Bo had to work, so we had to eat.
Yeah.
I want to do it later to watch my Cowboys play.
Mm.
Yeah, we made a nice breakfast and then didn't eat lunch and had dinner at 5:30.
I was trying to, like, if we do it later, you know, then it's not like 9 o'clock that you want to eat again.
Yeah.
Anybody go fishing?
We didn't. Squirrel hunting.
Did you?
Me and Bray went that morning.
Me and John have been fishing on Thanksgiving Day. It's amazing. There's nobody out there.
I've done that before in the past, but me and Bray, we went into the woods and it was quiet. It was windy.
Yeah.
It was windy and just no action, man.
Yeah.
Was the
weather good? I don't even remember what the weather was.
It was kind of overcast. '50s.
It was sunny.
It was comfortable. I was in a t-shirt most of the time.
Yeah, it was
like cooking.
It was mild. Yeah. It was mild.
I don't think I stepped out of the house on Thanksgiving Day.
It's a good day.
Yeah. Dude, I slept on the couch. Like reclined back. I sat while that brisket was cooking. I set my alarm for every hour and a half so I could go check it.
Oh my God.
That's like when you got a
concussion. Hour and a half naps.
Yeah.
That's like the concussion protocol.
Yeah. And it wasn't even for the I knew the meat was fine.
Yeah.
But I was worried about running out of pellets.
Yeah.
Like that's my biggest complaint is the hopper size. Like
you better make sure you have extra of those because at 3 o'clock if you ran out of pellets on Thanksgiving Day you probably ain't getting pellets unless you know somebody.
No, I've got a big hopper thing.
Yeah.
My brother-in-law actually got it for me, and you just filled up. It's 50 pounds. You put 50 pounds of pellets in it. So.
That's cool.
There you go.
Yep.
Very nice. Very nice.
So, anyways, let's talk some fishing products.
Let's do. Yeah.
Do y'all want to talk about these guys first or the waders that are laying over there?
So, at the end of the day, there's a lot of – it's every spring, let's just say that. That is usually when most manufacturers has their
– That's their big
– their big release of the season is going to be the spring season.
Which means January.
Which, correct, means January. So, usually between January to March, April, May – depending on what product it is they're releasing, there's different release dates, and that's when those products hit your shops. Mm-hmm. Folks like us is when we get those things. Now, however, we do get to see not all of those products, but a lot of those products in advance. So you can look at your data, you know, projections, and then have an idea of what you want to order, and you place your preseason orders in the hopes that come spring,
everybody buys it.
Those orders show up, and we have the product for folks to buy. But there's a few changes coming down the pipe that I will let – I kind of turn it over a little bit because these guys know a little bit more about it. But there
is one
product that I actually tested for a couple of days that I can share with you there as well. So on the SIM side of things, what are we looking for? What's happening in the SIMs for 2023 that we need to be on the lookout for?
So the first thing, and we've already got a YouTube video up that Justin and Shannon did. It's the Freestone, the new release of an updated Freestone wader for SIMs. So there's a video on YouTube right now that everybody can go look and see it and all that good stuff. And Shannon talks about the features, all that stuff, which it's got the normal features that waders has, but it's upgraded from the original or from the current Freestone wader, I guess I should say. So with that, between the fact that they've updated it and added more stuff to the wader and the cost of materials to make the waders, it's gone up to $379. So $380 from what was it at? I don't even remember what it was.
Oh, it's an $80 increase.
$80.
$300, $299.
So if you want to save some money.
Come buy what we got right now.
Kind of buy what we have in stock currently.
You know, they redid the entire Freestone line on the wader. So you've got the regular stocking foot for men's. It actually comes in two colors, a midnight and a smoke. The midnight, to me, is ugly.
It's like purple.
It's like bluey, purpley. It's weird.
Minnesota Viking uniform.
Then you got the regular kind of Sim smoke, which is that kind of that grayish, tannish kind of color combination. They got the pant, which comes in just that kind of tan color, gray color. And then the women's Freestone stocking foot. It's just kind of a charcoaly gray and lighter gray. So those are kind of the options on it. They are coming out with a new tributary wader also. A couple different colors in the men's stocking foot there. Well, let's talk price first. So the tributary is going up from kind of the same thing. They've upgraded a little bit and just cost of materials. So it's going from $200 to $230 basically. So a $30 increase there. Comes in two colors. You got the basalt and the regiment camo olive drab. So they've got a camo option in a semi price point wader, which is nice for those people that maybe do a little duck hunting or something like that on the side, or, you know, want to be super stealthy in the national park, right? So
see, that's what we were kind of alluding to yesterday with our rep. Why can't we just call it camo
instead of regiment? What is it? Regiment,
I mean,
camo,
it's like
olive drab.
Crayons.
I don't know.
Like, this is getting silly.
Yeah.
Is there a contract, like this camo they got from somebody, this pattern that they're having?
Yeah,
to
like regiments.
Like
when they had veil camo?
Yes.
Or, good Lord.
I'm just curious.
That's not worth the price of ink to print that long a name.
Right.
So you got that, and then you also have the women's one. Does that one have a pant?
No.
No?
No, okay. They don't have a pant. No.
So that's kind of where we're at on the new waders for Sims.
Yeah, I can't just shake my head. I got to say no.
Get with it. Oh, and they got a new kid's stocking foot for tributary too. It's a little cheaper. It comes in at $179, $180.
Oof, that's a price increase.
So it is. Yeah.
That's what the tributary used to cost for grownups.
Yep.
Yes.
So
not too terribly long ago.
Yeah,
actually,
a year ago.
Mm-hmm. As far as footwear for Sims coming out in the spring, they've updated the G4 boots. So got the Vibram and felt option still. I know we had a guy get some G4 boots not too long. Those things are pretty sweet.
It's like a $500 boot, yeah. Right?
It is. It's $499.
They're nice.
The major difference in those is they actually have different studs that the other boots do. So if anybody's familiar with how golf shoes work, where the studs on the golf shoes screw in and there's an actual spot for them built into the shoe, that's how the G4s are. So you have to buy a different type of stud for them that they sell, and it actually screws in. So those days of your studs popping out are over as long as you keep those tight.
Maybe.
What so. I like, too, with the felt, and, well, maybe the new ones are like that, too, but the felt, it even have, like, the lugs on the outside and then a place to put the studs
yes.
around the outside.
Yeah.
You know, some of the other, you know, companies' felt boots, you couldn't do that, which I thought that was a nice touch.
Yeah, yeah.
A little extra traction there if you need it.
Again, they updated the Freestone line, so all the Freestone boots are redone. They have a, you know, rubber sole in those, a felt sole in those, in men's and women's. Those are all coming in at $200, which off the top of my head, I don't remember what the other – I want to say they were $179 for the other free –
They were.
The current Freestones.
Yeah.
So a couple new things there in the boots. They also have a Fly Access wet wading shoe, which is ugly, in my opinion. I think everybody here said it was ugly.
It's kind of like a –
let me see it. I haven't seen it.
It's hard to tell here. When you see it in person, it is.
When y'all were kids, did y'all ever see those – they were called, I think they were called moon shoes, but they were like the boots with the springs in them that you could jump.
I don't know if I remember,
you don't remember
those,
this? Oh, I got to find it then.
That must be some Central North Carolina.
That's right up here.
Davidson County.
So – moon shoes with springs. So that's what they remind me of. They look awful.
So they have the sock built in?
Yeah, there's like a little neoprene sock built into them. Yeah. Honestly, don't remember.
You never saw them things?
I probably did, just don't remember them. So.
Yeah, I don't know about that. I mean, I'll wear them. You know, if they're comfortable, I'll wear them. But
yeah.
We would put them shoes with the springs on and then lower the basketball goal to like 8 foot and try to dunk.
You remember wearing them?
You had some of those?
Man.
You talking about like those shoes from East Bay that tried to make you jump higher?
No,
these
are
like,
cheaper than that.
Oh, okay.
Like they got a box under them.
Oh, I had never seen those. But you remember the shoes from East Bay
yeah.
that kind of had, it was supposed to, I
build
guess,
your calf.
Build your calf up there.
Shape ups.
probably one of them Bobby Hurley's dad's inventions there, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So as far as the waiting stuff from Sims, that's kind of the big stuff from them. You know, they're obviously going to have their shirts that they do. They're going to change some colors. I know a lot of people like them. They do that every year, just kind of go through the colors. I was going to roll back here to the accessories for spring just to see. Same thing with hats, with shirts, you know, they kind of the same styles, but new colors.
Some new colors on those Freestone nippers that I like so much.
New colors?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Yeah.
So they got a couple boat bags that Sims is coming out with, the Dry Creek collection, which has been around for several years now. They've updated the large boat bag and the small boat bag. So $349 for the large, $299 for the small. So if you need a new boat bag, those are coming out. You might want to check those out in the spring somewhere. What else we got here in the accessories and bags and bags? Taco bags, man. There's a ton of new colors of taco bags. So if you're in the market for a taco bag, they're going to stay around that $50 price point. So along with the orange and the anvil that we've had, they're adding a blue and a fuchsia, which is kind of that pinky purple, a camo in a carbon and an olive drab. So you got a couple camo options there. So that's kind of cool to get those.
I've sold four of those this week.
The taco bags, man.
It's a great gift.
It's a great gift.
Well, people come in and ask me too, and I'll tell, you know, they're like, I'm like, what's your budget? I'm like, $50. Mm-hmm. I'm like, well, here's a couple options, but I tell everybody, this is something that I didn't think that I ever needed, and then I got it. I don't know if I can live with it. I've got two of them, you know? Like,
Yeah, they're cool.
I use them all the time.
I've always said bang for buck. That's probably one of the best things Sims has. You know?
Yeah. You really invest in waiters, go ahead and spend $48 and get a taco bag.
Yeah, go ahead and get them. It's pretty
sweet. Protect your neoprene booty. Protect your automobile. Yep. It's real simple.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Some of the accessories, like Dale mentioned, in the Freestone Nipper, they got some new colors. They got it's kind of, they're going after the same colors as the taco bag. They got the fuchsia and the Nightfall and all that stuff.
Do they have the regiment?
They don't have the camo. In the Freestone Nipper. That might have, I guess, been hard to make in a plastic to make it mix. But if you haven't seen that Freestone Nipper drop by the store, it's basically a $25 plastic nipper, and it's super light. That's probably the biggest advantage of it.
Made in the USA.
I was going to say made in the USA. It's only got one blade on it, but it cuts. Man.
Yeah, yeah.
It cuts well.
I think it's Montana made too.
They got a couple of their small accessories, you know, new retractor and stuff like that. They fish do have
whistle
some,
4.0.
They don't have a new fish whistle out, but they still have that. Waiting belts. They've come out with some new waiting belts. So if you want, you know, a little splash on your waders, you can get an orange and a camo. A couple different colors of camo, and then they're coming out with some a teal and a fuchsia. So you got those guys, and that's about it for the spring for Sims. So definitely the big hit there is the waders, you know, the new Freestone collection, the new Tributary collection. I say that's probably the biggest things. So y'all want to jump into the fall for Sims since we saw that yesterday? So fall won't be here until like August, just so people know. So some of this stuff's new. No new waders, no new boots for fall. Probably the biggest thing in fall, other than they changed a bunch of sportswear, is Sims's. And from what we were told yesterday, and again, with problems getting stuff, this could change. But we were told that these would possibly be available in May, not in August. So if we can get them sooner, we'll get them sooner. But Sims is finally coming out with a net. A landing net, you know, to catch a fish in when you got him hooked. Mm-hmm. So they're going to have a small and a medium, as they call it, which tells me they might have a large at some point, which is like a boat net. So the small is a regular hand net, you know, the size that most people are familiar with. And then they also have one that's kind of what we call the mid-length net that a lot of people use that have sling packs where they can slide it in like a sword in the back. So price points on those, hand net, $159. The larger one, which is more like that mid-length net, $199. So it's wrapped in Kevlar, kind of like what the River Armor from Fish Pond's like. So they're in that same price point as what those Fish Pond River Armor nets are at. So that's like the biggest thing besides sportswear and stuff, you know, new colors and shirts and stuff for the fall. So fall's always a smaller release. Usually spring's bigger. Shannon mentioned that earlier. They do have like some new, you know, small accessory items like bottle holders and stuff like that, but nothing too crazy coming out in the fall. But that's the big highlights of Sims for 23 as of now, unless something crazy happens and changes. Like I said, that Freestone video you guys got up on YouTube, y'all mm-hmm. did a really good job on that. And so that'll give you guys, if you want to see them, Shannon's actually got them where you can touch where he can touch and feel and show you some stuff on them, so you can kind of see the new look on those.
And as these new products come out, you know, our goal is to keep, you know, making these YouTube videos and, you know, letting you guys see this stuff as soon as we can get our hands on it, too.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. I'll let Shannon talk about the next one because he demoed it on the water for a couple of days this past week. So go for it, man.
Yeah, so did a stream report Friday. Jarrett was with me and Brian was with me over there on the water. Brian and his dad and brother we had for a couple of days guiding, and as we were finishing up the day, I took the little camera and said, tell me what you see. And a couple of people did comment on the channel right there, but Grundon's has entered the fly fishing wader game.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's safe to say that. And what I actually had a chance to wear for a couple of days was a Gore-Tex wader from Grundon's that I'll let these guys kind of go into detail here. Because we're going to have those in the spring. Don't know exactly when in the spring. And it's a really neat wader. They've really, really thought this out. And before you say, well, Grundon's, what's Grundon's? Grundon has been in the fishing industry for a long time. Yeah. More likely than not, you have probably seen someone wearing a pair of Grundon's waders on a fishing boat, whether it was a commercial fishing application. You have seen Grundon's waders out there. They've decided to jump into the trout game, per se, or maybe say the fly fishing game, per se. And it's a really neat design. You've got it's a body map, three-layer and four-layer Gore-Tex Pro fabric. Excellent breathability, excellent abrasion resistance. It's got optimal articulation, and it's basically a five-panel design where the way the panels are on it, it allows you to move freely throughout the water with no restrictions. And it is one of those things that is really neat, and I really enjoyed wearing that wader. The suspender system is something that you've not seen on any of the other fly fishing waders on the market right now. It is a fused and contour suspension system. It is a much wider strap that comes across your shoulder blades. And I will show this to you when we do make a video for this here, and you'll understand it better. But you've got adjustments in the back as well as on your straps, buckles, areas on the front.
And this is a suspender package that you typically would only get from Sims on the G4.
Yeah, I mean, but this one's different with that Velcro option in the back.
It is, but this is... I think this
the padded suspend,
it's going to be super comfortable.
Yes, it was. The booty, the neoprene booty is different on this particular wader here. I will tell you that on Friday, it was cold that morning, and I elected not to wear a toe warmer on purpose. I wanted to see, based upon this design of this neoprene booties and this particular one here, my feet did not get cold where Jarrett, Kevin, Mike, and those guys, all of them, they said, well, my feet got cold. My feet stayed warm. I did not wear, on either day, Friday or Saturday, I did not wear a
Do you have neuropathy?
Excuse me?
Do you have neuropathy?
No.
Just making sure.
No.
Got to have the control there.
Yeah. No, exactly. So once again, kind of comparing, and when I go over this design and I show you and I turn this inside out, you will see why. One of the it's a double weave stretch woven gravel guard. It's unlike anything I've seen before. When you roll that gravel guard up, it's got some texturing to it as well. Mm-hmm. So it grips exceptionally well. So it's not pulling up. There's no buckle on it to hook onto your wading boot, which some have a place for it and some don't. This grips exceptionally well, and it rolls up really high. So if you have a taller wading boot, you're going to be able to get that wading boot on with this here too. And another thing I'll point out in the video is the fact that if you have an issue with your booty and you need to send it back for a warranted repair, the way that this is designed, they can go in and replace that booty without damaging the structural integrity of the upper part or the lower and the upper part of that wader. It's a really, really neat thought out design. Great pocket system in it. This is a wader that I felt very comfortable in, and it's, I would say, between the Orvis and the Sims I wore and the Patagonia, it is the best fitting wader that I've ever put on.
Yeah, and it's you guys will see, you got to keep an eye on the YouTube videos. It'll pop up here probably in the next, I don't know, 2-3 weeks. We might have it up, I'd say, by the time we get it recorded and get it out there and scheduled and everything. But it's kind of in that same colorway as the traditional Sims. It's kind of got that tannish gray kind of color. So it's, a nice mixture of color with black, stocking foot, black suspenders, things like that. They come in three different styles is what they're coming out with. And again, they're just coming out with these, so I think they're going to expand this. But you got the men's boundary zip stocking wader. So it's got a zip front, that a lot of people like that. And then it's got the boundary stocking foot, which is the same wader, just without a zip front. Mm-hmm. And then the women's boundary stocking foot. Now, they're not offering the women's yet in a zipper. I think that might come down the line, just depending on, timing and all that stuff. but those are the three options. If I remember right, don't quote me on this, but I'm pretty sure it's $549 and $649. So $549 for the regular and $649 for the zipper. Don't quote me on that. I'm trying to remember that off the top of my head because I don't have it in front of me. A lot of prices to remember. They also are coming out with the boots, which we've seen. We haven't been able to test those because the sizes we saw were like, I don't know, size 8.
They were 2 left feet.
Yeah, and they were both 2 left feet.
They were 2 left feet.
So yeah, so we didn't get to see or test the boots, I should say.
Yeah.
So they're coming out with a Bedrock wading boot, which is a Vibram. So all their boots are Vibram. Well, I shouldn't say that. They do have a felt and Vibram hybrid, kind of like what the Orvis did on their pro boot. But they've got the Bedrock Vibram, then they got the Bedrock Vibram and felt, which is the hybrid. And then they got the women's Vibram and felt hybrid. So the women's isn't going to come in a Vibram, just solely Vibram. It's going to be a it does come in both. Sorry. It does come in a Vibram and a felt hybrid. So so there's some boot options there to go along with the waders. I have a feeling most of the time if you've been in fly fishing, you either need boots or you need waders. You don't usually need the whole setup all at once. So, depending on what you're looking for. Come in and check them out, touch them, feel them. Like I said, Shannon's going to put a video up with them there, so that'll be cool. We're excited for them. It's another Gore-Tex wader to the market. So that's only good for everybody as far as, it's going to breed that competition between Sims and Grundins to see, who can provide the best wader over the next few years.
Well, and not just waders from Grundins.
Yeah,
I'm excited to see a Gore-Tex jacket that's more affordable.
Yeah, they're
$300 Gore-Tex jacket. There's I think there's one that's maybe like $249 that's a Gore-Tex pullover rain jacket,
like a rain shell.
Yeah. So and then they've got just like a regular rain jacket that's $99.
Yeah.
I mean, I think to get that with Patagonia now it's $179.
And I think part of that is, Grundins, if you're in the fly fishing, you may not have heard of Grundins like Shannon was speaking earlier, but Grundins is worldwide in the commercial fishing industry. So their volume is where I think they can justify their price points is because they're instead of selling 100 rain jackets, just using this as a hypothetical, they're selling 1,000 compared to Sims selling 100. So they can get better pricing on bulk. Lowers their price point to retail.
They've been on boats a long time, though.
Oh, a long, long time. Yeah.
So, yeah. I mean, this isn't like a new thing for them to make raincoats. The waders is the only new thing.
Yeah.
They've got some, sun hoodies and things like that, as well as some layering stuff.
The boots, the nice, rubber pullover boots.
Mm-hmm. So is there any other products? So we're going to bring a wader in.
We're bringing in
some sun hoodies.
Yeah, but I can't remember our order because I did it months ago. But sure. We're bringing in 4 different apparel items.
Okay.
So socks. Basically, it'll fill a 4-way. Okay. We held off on the socks.
Oh.
I think, if I remember right, because we have so many from Sims still.
That's right.
But we'll probably bring some in. We're bringing in their sandals, which are really sweet.
Sandals are the flip-flops. Sandals are nice.
I should call them flip-flops. Yeah, they have a C-deck insert. On the for you to stand on, which is sweet.
It is actually
that C deck is so comfortable.
It is. Yeah. It is. At first, it was like I was a little apprehensive.
Yeah,
but no, it's
comfy.
It's nice.
So, they're definitely got some cool stuff that's awesome for the shop and for the consumer. So, we're excited to bring them in, see what they can have, and we're actually probably midwinter, late winter, early spring. Gonna try to have Jimmy in here, who's our rep for him, and he can give you more technical info. Have him on the podcast. Probably do like a demo day type thing where you can come out and see them. They're gonna bring a drift boat in. That's
fantastic.
Decorated up with Grundins, all this stuff. So all that's in the pipeline to come down. And as soon as we know a day that we can do that and have customers come out and hang out and like I said, see more than just the waders. Like he'll probably have a lot of the apparel where it'll give us a better idea for our next order, our next preseason, like what you guys are into is fly fishing, on what to bring in and have for you. So we're excited. It's a new company in the fly fishing industry that has been around and proven for years. So I think the quality is going to be there. Like I said, we like the pricing, all that good stuff. So I'm excited for it.
It's kind of a breath of fresh air, really.
It is. It is.
Because we've seen everything in the industry just like the consumers just get hammered with price increases.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's kind of nice to get a breather. I mean, I know that these prices will eventually go up too, but it's going to force some people to it's going to hold their feet to the fire and be like, really, you want to go to 1,000?
Yeah.
You really want to do that?
Yeah. So I'm excited to see what they come out with, you know, for fall of next year, because this is just the spring release that we've seen. So I'm excited for fall. I'm excited for 24 to see what they grow. Jimmy hinted to they might be bringing out more of a price point waiter, possibly. So that would be maybe a competitor for the Freestone or the Tributary in that realm. Mm-hmm. You know, that maybe 200 to 350 ish, 400 price points, somewhere in there. So that'd be cool if they can do that, you know. So yeah, I'm excited.
On the waiters, it was a March release.
Yeah. By the way, the waiters, I think the ship date was March 15th. So hopefully by the end of March, we'll actually have some in store, so that people can come by and check them out.
And we'll certainly put it up on social and have it available on flyshopusa.com.
So sure. Some exciting things. It is. Like I said, Dale said, breath of fresh air, just something new, different. I think from a consumer, I can like put myself in being a customer, you know, whatever, 10, 12 years ago. Like when stuff like this came, I was like, oh, dude, I want to see that, you know? So I think that's going to be the hype for the industry as far as the customer base is just coming in and checking out something new. You'll probably start seeing it, or you may already have. It's probably in magazines already. They're putting a ton of money in advertising to let people know that they're doing this. So, me and Dale, we went and fished for Albies a couple weeks ago, so we bought some bibs from them and some of the rubber boots that you wear, like, on a boat, you know?
Yeah.
Or Dale's wearing them today because it's raining.
They come in great when you're helping with the elementary school car drop-off in the mornings.
Yeah, stay dry.
Stay dry. I'm out there in the rain for 45 minutes straight. My feet stay dry.
So speaking of, like, that type of shoe you have on now, is that something potentially that we may
We brought in one color.
Okay.
I brought in a size run in that color just to kind of see
looking
the
at those.
So the boot that I'm talking about, the one that Dale's got on, it's kind of like just above your ankle. And if anybody's familiar with Extra Tough, you've probably heard that name. This is very similar to that. They're actually made in the same factory as Extra Tough. It's just the Grundin's design, their bottom, that type of stuff on it.
Okay.
Yeah, you were talking about arch support.
Yeah.
Guess what I found last night?
That's got an insole?
You can remove it.
Oh.
So
you could put your own insole.
You could put
in
your
it.
Own insert yeah. in.
How do your feet doing those? Are they sweaty?
If you have the heat blasting on them, yeah.
My feet sweat regardless. As I'm sitting here barefoot.
Okay.
So I don't know that I'm a best judge of that. They don't smell bad yet. So they still smell like rubber boots. But they're great on the roof when you're hanging Christmas lights.
Okay. All right.
Because they are razor siped. So there's full
The siping is fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah. They actually have a lip here to prevent your fly line from going up under your foot.
Okay.
So if you're doing any casting, fly casting while wearing those, that'll be a good.
That design of boot though in the last 3-4 years has exploded.
It's like people, you see it a lot, right?
That little the ankle kind of style. I mean, it's great. Like last night I took my pair. I had to walk down and grab just a bundle of firewood.
Sure.
And I just kicked my feet in and walked down there, got it cuz it was raining.
Yeah.
Had to go take care of the chickens. Boom, things on.
I'm always putting on the big muck boots. That right there could be definitely an alternative going out.
Yeah, it's a lot harder to put on those calf high muck boots.
Oh my gosh, man, I'm stepping.
Really? Yeah. It can't. It's not that much more energy.
It
to
is.
Put on. No.
It is.
But I mean, it's like you're those trying to get your pants inside of them. And
those right there, I don't have to touch them. I can just stick my foot in them.
Yeah.
It's like, so I feel like I
got more of a.
I don't have to pull them up, but my muck boots, I got to like. Work them and flip the thing.
But anyway, so we'll have that. That would be a paradigm shift. We've not really had like footwear.
And if it does well, we'll probably expand it into all three shops and get some different colors. And again, it's about interest. You know, as a company, we can't buy stuff that's not going
to
sell.
It takes a lot of money to sell shoes too.
Yeah, because it's sizes. Yeah, you got to have tons of sizes, different colors. Like it's a lot of money to invest that for something that may or may not move. I think they'll move as far as you guys buying them. But I got to be sure of that before I, you know, say, hey, let's buy a bunch.
Right. When will this stuff drop? Or when will this stuff? Will it be like the March date?
Some of this stuff's coming in earlier. I don't remember our ship date off the top
January
of my head.
January or February.
But it's January or February. Cool. That stuff will start shipping in. We'll start doing reviews on it.
Yeah.
We'll do some videos hey, this came in from Grundin's. And,
perfect.
Nice.
Perfect.
I think it's important to let people see it and touch it and feel it. And hopefully it grows with us and grows in the industry. And again, there's that saying, and I think it holds true. It's not always true, but it's, you know, competition breeds excellence. Sometimes that's good. So competition can also breed bad things, but a lot of times it breeds excellence. So, you know, it's another game changer for people to compare against, that they go, this has got this and this has got that. And then next year Sims puts whatever Grundin's had, or Grundin's puts whatever Sims had in their waiter, and you know, you just get a better product hopefully over time. So
absolutely.
You know, I think it's nice to have another Gore-Tex waders. The Sims was the only game for Gore-Tex waders other than Sitka, which is, you know, super, super pricey.
And those were for duck hunting applications. That wasn't for fishing.
Yeah, so it's nice to have somebody in the fly fishing application with Gore-Tex waders. So the one difference, I will mention this, that I didn't mention, is Grundon's Gore-Tex waders will be made overseas, where Sims are still going to be made in Montana. So that's, you know, depending on where you are on all that, not to get political or anything, but, you know, that may be a selling decision for you. The difference is when you see Sims pricing compared to Grundon's, Sims are going to cost more. It's made in America. Labor costs more. So, you know, if that's something that's important to you, by all means, that's the reason we have Sims and Grundon's, right?
That's right. Absolutely.
As Shannon said, in the car industry, there's a butt for every seat.
Amen to that, brother. No matter how good it looked or how ugly the car was, it worked, baby. Yeah, there's somebody that liked it. No doubt about that, for sure. Is there any other, away from kind of here with this, is there any maybe reels or rods or things that we're not aware of that maybe we should be on the lookout for?
There's no major new rods coming into the industry, but we are bringing in a couple new brands to the shop.
Okay. Well, TNT makes a return. Thomas & Thomas makes a return.
Yeah, before. Yeah, we've always been a Thomas & Thomas dealer, but we're going to start carrying some in the shop for folks. We got the Winstons. I still got to finish that order, but I was emailing with Guy yesterday about it. We're going to bring some Winston in.
Okay.
And then we also have Douglas rods that we're going to bring in. And then Abel, as far as reels, we're going to bring in some Abel.
Okay. Ross has been fantastic for us this year.
So yeah, if anybody doesn't know, Ross and Abel are the same company. So we're going to bring a few Abels in on top of the Rosses that we already have, just because they're pretty, man. They're pretty reels.
And those brook trout Abels are gorgeous.
Yeah, they are. They're nice reels. So, you know, when we start getting some of that stuff in, we'll probably sit down and do a video on them.
Sure,
you know,
absolutely. Yep.
Just so people can see what they look like and stuff. I think most people know what the Rosses look like. It's been advertised. Ross came out with a new color that, like, olive.
Where are they at? I thought we were getting those.
We are. They're coming in the spring. We didn't order any for the fall.
I've had my hopes up for like 2 months about that. Really.
He's ready to see it.
Yeah.
So we got that stuff coming in as far as new stuff for the shop. Like I said, none of that stuff is new to the market, really. None of them came out with the Zone nymphing rod from TNT is new.
Yeah, that's brand new.
I forgot about that.
$495 price point, I think.
Yeah. So TNT offers Thomas & Thomas offers the Zone, which is kind of their mid price point. And they're coming out with a nymphing stick in that price point. So that'll be something. But other than like new rod technology, the newest one coming out is from Sage, which is the R8, which has already came out, but they're coming out with the saltwater one. So it'll have saltwater components on it.
Scott come up with the Wave, but that hit this fall.
Yeah, that's been a few months now.
Yeah.
There's probably a couple other things that are new. Hey, grab one of them nets, Justin, from Orvis. Okay. That's something that's new that people may not have seen that we can flash up. It's already come out this fall, but if you haven't seen it, it's kind of a cool look. Oh, do you? Okay.
Is it out yet? I didn't think the video dropped yet. And I will tell you, this net design here, the basket is exceptionally deep on it. And my 12-year-old walked in here when we first got him, and I said, hey, take a look at that net.
Just hold it up in front of you.
And he picked it up, and he was looking, and he goes, I like the shape of that. It'd be easier to land a fish with that shape of a basket there. And but the contours of this particular net fit exceptionally well in the Orvis sling packs, their pack system that they have.
Yeah.
They really fit really nice. Even this hand net style, the shorter handle, fits very snugly in there.
Yeah,
well, which is nice.
This is the smaller one we have. You know,
there's a mid-length.
Right.
Yeah. So, you know, that's something that they shipped those, I think, November, whatever, 10th or something was our ship date that those were released. So they're really new. Like, they've only been in the shop for 3 weeks or something like that. So
the video for these will be up next week.
Okay. Well, there you
Probably
go.
Probably next Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah, so go check out the YouTube video. You can see them all, the longer one and everything, and here's maybe some specs or whatever on them and all that good stuff. So, yeah, I feel like that's it. Somebody's vibrating again. We got phones ringing.
Dale, phone is blowing up.
Well, I have one question, you know, maybe just quick.
What's the weather?
We're talking of, it's raining outside. Swell day to be a duck.
Swell.
Sorry. So we're talking about 2023 product. What has been your favorite product for 2022 that's dropped this year.
Man, that came out, that was new. Man, you should have prepared me for this question, right?
Yeah. Well,
you know, got one in your head already.
No, I was just there thinking about it. I'm like, I wonder what. Well, I've been thinking about it while we were going through this. You know, what's been my favorite product that's dropped this year? You know, whether it was like the new Freestone nipper from Sims, or if it was a new rod, or you know, what is something that.
You know what? I don't know if it was new to this year, but I was super impressed by it. Is that the high-end waiting staff from Sims? That thing is awesome. Now, it is pricey. It's $230.
Yeah.
But it's $230 of quality. It blows every waiting staff on the market out of the water, and it should. That thing is fantastic. I think we're down to one. We probably need to order some more.
Carbon Pro waiting staff.
Yeah, that thing is. I was really impressed. I'm pretty hard on waiting staffs, not using them, just critiquing them, because I'm like, this thing's wobbly. It pulls apart in the mud. Blah blah.
You're a big guy though.
Yeah. So it's like when you.
I don't trust half of them out there. I'm gonna tell you.
As Shannon told a customer one day, and I think it might have sold it. It's $230 is steep. But it's a lot cheaper than going to the hospital.
Yep.
So if you want a good quality waiting staff that looks like it's going to last you a very long time, as long as you take care of it and don't run it over with your car, I'm pretty impressed by that.
It's it is made in Austria.
Yeah.
It's Austrian made, and those people do a lot of stuff with poles over there, such as skiing.
We did a video on that.
We did a video on that as well. It goes together quite nicely. And I you kind of caught me off guard with that too. I'd like to know what the folks comment down below. Tell us what you think is the coolest product that's come out, of course, in 22. We'd like to hear from you about that. But they did a good job. Sims, in my opinion, was behind the eight ball in waiting staff quality.
Yeah.
I mean, let's just
already
say,
compared to who?
They weren't great. They were weak.
Compared to that?
Oh, that thing there is a step back.
Orvis waiting staff.
Yeah, that one there. But
I liked the Orvis bungee one that snaps together.
Yeah, the
I always liked
boom,
that.
Boom, I've got a couple
now,
of those.
Now, it would pull apart in the mud, but that's part of having a bungee.
It is much heavy. But the Sims waiting staff struggled. This one here, they hit it. They hit it out of the ballpark for sure.
Yeah.
So I'm giving them credit where credit's due.
Yeah.
Great job with that. And it is the cheapest insurance policy you can have.
Yeah.
Hands down, is that.
That and good wading boots.
Yes.
I'd say they're right there.
You go hand in hand. It's a system.
Yeah. What was yours, Justin, since you kind of brought the question?
Mine's probably a boot. Probably that Orvis hybrid boot, just for my fishing application.
Yeah.
That or maybe even the access boot.
And I was going to say mine's a flyweight access.
Yeah, I like that, and they seem that both of those boots seem to get I get a lot of people interested in that. When I mention it to them, in the store, stuff like that, if I show that boot to them, they're like, oh, this is really not. And there's a big, really good feedback from that boot. I like the, and that's what I mentioned a minute ago with the Sims G4 boot, where they have that lug on the, that new hybrid boot kind of has that same type thing with that lug on the outside. Because that's my biggest complaint with felt. if you're climbing a bank or something like that, it's slick.
If
the leaves and the grass
or whatever.
So just that little extra traction. So
that's usually where I fall, is getting in and out of the river, not in the river.
Right.
You slip or something trying to get in or out or whatever. And
You'll wade through waist-deep water, then fall on dry ground.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So those are all good. I mean,
it's hard. I mean, there's so much rod technology and stuff coming out, these last year or two as well.
I would say Matt would probably pick that wave. He really liked that wave.
Man, that wave
Scott.
Is a cannon.
Yeah, you guys fished that down in Charleston, right?
Yeah. Until homeboy stepped on it. That's all right.
Yeah, if you step on a Scott wave, it breaks. I think any rod breaks when you step on it. So.
It's impressive. I liked what I had a saltwater taper line on it. And it was
great.
It was nice for that. Yeah.
Is that the rod he caught his redfish on?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's sweet, man.
Yep.
That's good. That's good stuff, man. Well, fishing report. You guys fished with clients this past weekend, so y'all probably have a better idea. I know it's probably changed because we've had, an inch and a half of rain.
When that weather first hit Saturday, that fishing was awful.
It turned for sure.
It was bad.
We had a good day on Friday.
Fork of the pigeon.
Yeah. Friday was a good day before the system was rolling in on top of us there. But, we had higher water on the Tuckasegee on Saturday, so we had to avert good plan B.
Yeah.
Which, fortunately for us is, you know what? We have options here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, we have options. And we went there, and it definitely wasn't stellar for sure. I'll tell you that. We seen fish. Kevin did everything I asked.
Shots. People had shots at fish.
Yeah. I mean, there was some fish on, but just – it's tough to seal the deal.
You think it's because the front was pushing in that it just kind of put
them
down?
The sun would come out. I mean, the barometer's all over the place.
Yeah. It'd rain. It wouldn't rain. The water clarity was clear. I had no problem with the water clarity at all.
Yeah.
But they were just real finicky. And when you had your chance, you had to make good on your
chances. I think
that's
the biggest thing about when weather's coming through. Like today, I mean, we got trips out on the water today in this rain. And it's all about, you're going to have your shot, but you can't miss it.
Yeah. So, but at the end of the day, they did well. They caught a lot of fish definitely on day one.
Mm-hmm.
And that day definitely fished differently. The rain we're getting is, it's a good soaking rain.
It is, man. It's a slow.
We've really needed this.
It's funny, the other day, a trip called that we had later for this week and was like, yeah, are we going to be able to go? It looks like you guys have got a lot of rain. And Adam was on the phone. He's like, yeah, we got quite a bit today. And Adam got off the phone and I said, how much rain do you think we've gotten? And he said, oh, at least over a quarter of an inch. And Sarah was here, and I asked her, and they were both in the same realm. And I looked it up, and we had 0.08 at my rain gauge. And I was like, it's crazy how it rains all day, and it's like, man, we barely got anything.
Right, right.
So it's a good soaking rain. Now we're up to like an inch and a half.
And that's where those weather systems are, gauging stations come into play. You can kind of see, but it's over a period of time the way we're getting this rain. So this is a good rain.
Like the tuck this morning didn't look
bad. Right. You can still fish.
I was blown away.
The water clarity on the Scotts Creek, we know how it gets.
Yeah.
It's not bad as well. So this is a good rain. It's going to help us going forward. The temperatures, the water temperatures are back up again. With this rain, the water temp has risen again. And that's what we're struggling with too. You know, we've been up and down, and it cooled off again for us there Saturday morning. We that cooler night.
Yeah.
Drop the water temp there for us. So what we had success on Friday was blooming olive emergers, some rubber leg patterns. Of course, I did well with an olive sculpin pattern that we sell here in the shop.
Yeah.
They would react to that. Then by the time we were leaving, we were starting to see some midges, which I think a midge dry, you know, would have been really good. When I say midge, I'd be like an 18 or a 20, I think you'd been fine with. And, you know, a dry dropper that afternoon because, you know, the blooming olives were starting to pop off.
Yeah.
And we were done at that point because they had things that had to do with their mom. So I kind of see that going forward as we get into the holidays. It's always a good time to fish here.
Yeah.
So if you come to spend Christmas in the mountains, as a lot of you folks do, bring your gear.
Yeah.
You'll have some opportunities to fish here.
Yeah, the 2 week forecast. I mean, I saw some 20s and some, you know, chance at maybe a little bit of snow and stuff, but most of the highs in the day is, you know, 45 to 55. Like it's in that kind of range for the next 2 weeks. So I think that's kind of the system we're in right now.
Can't beat it.
I hope we get a little snow. I'd rather have a little snow than a little, just a couple inches. Snow.
It'd help everybody's attitude a little bit.
Yeah.
It'd help everybody's attitude. I knew that, you know, Georgia Drifter had a couple of his buddies up, and they got
they got some nice fish. And they got that smallie.
Yeah, they got that smallmouth.
That was a big smallmouth.
That was a big smallmouth there in the Tuckasegee, folks. A big slab of smallmouth there for sure. And Fastwater Prince was on one of the flies. I got that one big fish there that I recommended. And a lot of opportunities for you. Just got to be here. Just got to be here, most importantly.
That's it, man.
Yeah.
That's
I hit on the hours 9 to 5.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's a good thing to mention that we're instead of 8 to 5, we're 9 to 5 in all three locations. Closed Sunday.
Let's see. Is Christmas Eve on a
– it's on a Saturday.
So
we're closing at 2 o'clock on Christmas Eve.
So keep that in mind, folks. Close at 2 o'clock on Christmas Eve. If you're going to order something online, do it sooner rather than later.
Yeah. For a gift. I think I saw what the USPS was the other day for shipping. I want to say it was either the 15th or the 17th.
So keep that in mind. FlyShopUSA.com.
Roughly 5 or 6 more days to get some stuff.
Yeah.
I think so. FlyShopUSA.com is where you're going to find those products. So if you do need to buy something online, do it sooner rather than later to ensure that you get there.
Yeah.
We have free shipping right now.
Yeah. We got free shipping for the holiday season.
Free shipping, baby.
Yeah. So that saves you a few bucks.
Heck yeah. I like that.
Check out the YouTube channel. Like I said, we've been – Justin and Shannon have been hammering it home, man. We got a ton of videos, new videos up in the last 3 weeks, four weeks, whatever it's been. So they're doing a fantastic job.
There was one day we recorded several
–
a couple of days. That's what we did. We recorded
like 7 videos, and it's just kind of
Yeah, trickling them out.
Added
yeah.
Them. Yeah.
So that stuff's coming.
We got some other stuff coming out and all the new content that with the new products, hopefully, as we get some of those in stock, we can show you those. So excited for that. So keep an eye on the YouTube channel and all that new stuff, stream reports, you know, whatever else we do.
Good deal. Excellent.
Whatever other crazy stuff we do.
Well, we're averaging like 3 to 4 videos a week on YouTube right now.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Give you a lot to watch at night.
Yeah, so we have new content coming out all the time. So
but anyways, hey, man, I appreciate everybody listening. Glad we were able to get in here this morning and make it happen. So let's go do something fun.
That wraps up another exciting and informative episode of the Tuckcast with a splash of bourbon, presented by Tuckasegee Fly Shop and Guide Service, located at 3 Depot Street, Bryson City, North Carolina, and 530 West Main Street, Silva, North Carolina. Be sure to visit www.tuckflyshop.com for streamflow information, book a guided trip, or even shop for your favorite Tuckasegee Fly Shop gear. Follow the crew on Facebook at Tuckasegee Fly Shop, Instagram at Tuck Fly Shop, and on YouTube at Tuckasegee Fly Shop. If you have a question or comment, feel free to send those to info@tuckflyshop.com or give us a call 1-828-488-3333. For Coach Dell Diesel Collins, Bobby the Bearded Wonder Bennett, I'm Shannon, Big Miss Messer. We'll catch you next week. Be sure to catch a few fish out there, won't you? Y'all take care.